one wishes for silver and gold. How do you measure its worth? Just by the pleasure it gives here on earth. Silver and gold, silver and gold, mean so much more when I see. Silver and gold decorations on every Christmas tree.
Hello, good morning, and welcome to Abundant Church. We're so excited and honored to have you all here for the Thrill of Hope service that we have going on. We have a lot happening today, and we're so excited for everything that you're going to see and experience as we go through the service. But before we get into it, there's just a few things that we want you all to be aware of and to know, so that way you don't get scared or anything like that. We just want you to be aware of all those things. But because it is the Christmas season, and this is always a season full of laughter, something that I always like to share with people are Christmas dad jokes. And so I just have a few dad jokes that I'm going to share with you this morning as we get started. But I don't know if you knew this, but there is the regular alphabet and there is the Christmas alphabet. And the only difference between the regular alphabet and the Christmas alphabet is the Christmas alphabet has Noel. It took a few of you a few seconds there to get it, but it's all right. It's okay. You know, it's understandable. You know, every Christmas, there's always one thing that shows up that's never hungry, and that's the turkey, because it's always stuffed. You know, yes, it's a free show, therefore the jokes are just as good as what you paid for. But truly, we are honored and we're so grateful to have you here this morning. And, you know, we just want to remind you, this is a big auditorium, and throughout the service, we are going to have dancers and different things coming up and down the aisle. And so we ask parents, if you have small children with you, please do not let them leave the auditorium unattended. If they are needed going to the restroom or anything like that, obviously they can go to the restroom, but we want you to walk them out, because we don't want them to get lost. We don't want them to trip on something, run into someone. We want everyone to have a safe and great experience. And also, if you can help us by making sure that your kids do not stand on the seats. Every seat in here is a great, great seat. And so we don't want to be blocking anyone behind you. And parents, that goes for you as well. Please don't stand on the seats. We know how much you enjoy doing that. And lastly, there is going to be a part of the show where we have some big beach balls that are going to be thrown into the crowd. And so just be aware of them. We don't want you to get knocked upside the head with a beach ball this morning. We want you to have a great, great we had a great time here at Abundant Church. That's everything that I have for you this morning. And would you please, we can start the show.
Jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way. Oh, what fun it is to ride in a 57 Chevrolet. Oh, jingle bell, jingle, jingle, jingle all the way. Oh, what fun it is to ride in a one-horse open sleigh. Dashing through the snow in a one-horse open sleigh. Over them fields we go, laughing all the way. Bells on bobtails ring, making their spirits bright. What fun it is to ride and sing a sleighing song tonight. Woo! Jingle bells, jingle, jingle, jingle all the way. Oh, what fun it is to ride in a 57 Chevrolet. Oh, jingle bells, jingle, jingle, jingle all the way. Oh, what fun it is to ride. Jingle all the way. Oh, I'm fine.
I hope you've been enjoying this show so far. We just want to take a quick moment to recognize anyone that may be here at Abundant Church for the very first time. And I know you are closely watching their cute and adorable faces as they come up here. But we want to welcome anyone that is here for the very first time, whether you're sitting here in the service or watching us online. If this is your very first time here at Abundant Church, would you do us a favor and just raise your hand at this moment so we can recognize you? And let's give them a round of applause as they raise their hands. Thank you so much. All throughout the room, we have so many first-time guests. Thank you for being here. If this is your very first time, you're going to see a QR code pop up on the screen. And we ask, if you can, to scan that code. That gives our team an opportunity to connect with you, to answer any questions that you may have. We want to make this the best possible experience that you can have. Also, we want to encourage you to stop by our Connect Centers out in the lobby where we have some people there that would love to meet you, answer any questions that you have there. But most importantly, we have a gift that we want to give you. We don't want you to leave today without receiving the free gift here from Abundant Church. We truly are honored and grateful to have you here. We have service every Sunday, 9, 10:45, and 12:30, and on Wednesday nights at 6:30. And we'd love to see you here. We'd love to see you come back here to Abundant Church. Well, that's everything I have for you today, and we're going to go ahead and continue on with the service.
Yourself on
bottom of the line. The fire is so delightful. Since we've no place to go, let it snow, let it snow, let it snow. It doesn't show signs of stopping, and I brought lots of corn for popping. Lights are turned down low. Let it snow, let it snow, let it snow. When we finally kiss goodnight, how I hate going out in the storm. But if you
Good morning. How are y'all doing so far? Are we good? How many of you love Jesus on this beautiful Sunday morning? Amen. I was kind of laughing. We're singing Let It Snow, and it's going to be almost 70 degrees today. So, yeah. By faith, let it snow. How many of you are so glad God is on your side today? Amen. Hey, thank you so much for being at church today. If you're new here, my name's Jared Neiman. I'm one of the pastors here. And we're going to move into a couple things and get back into the show. Before we do, we have a couple of video announcements that are highlighting some amazing things going on in our church. Would you please watch the screens? obviously that second video was a little recap of what we did this weekend as a church. We were in San Lazario yesterday, and you saw there we were able to feed 1,000 families. We gave them so many boxes of food that we had to have a team of volunteers that had wagons to be able to help the families take the food to their cars because, I mean, it was just so much. It was really amazing. And of course, all the kids got 2 toys each. Some of them, you know, they're sneaky. They get 3 or 4 toys. And, you know, I mean, if you just have a strong enough personality, sometimes you get more, you know? And, I mean, it was really such a blessing to be there. We had hundreds of volunteers. I mean, there were so many people. It was like a small army. And I just want to say thank you to all of you that served, and thank you to all of you that gave. And above the food and above the toys, our team told us that 149 people prayed the prayer of salvation to receive Jesus as their Lord and Savior. Every person in the line was given the opportunity to be prayed for, and many people were, and it was fantastic. They told me that 12 entire families, I guess that means like the mom, the dad, and the kids, prayed the prayer to receive Jesus as their Lord. So isn't that amazing to think that the eternal destiny of entire families changed yesterday? And I don't know about you, but that's what it's all about. Amen. And I got to tell you, I just love the toy giveaway. I was standing there when they started it, and the kids come around. They set up these buses, and the kids come around, and there's the toys. It's like a wall of toys. And there was this little girl. She was just so precious. She had her hair in pigtails, probably 7, 8 years old. And she came around, and she saw him, and me and one of the guys were standing there, and her face just lit up, and she got so excited. She literally started jumping. Like, I'm not kidding. She started jumping, saying, "Mom, Mom, look! Mom, look!" Bouncing in the air. And I thought to myself, I wonder if she realizes she's jumping or she's just so excited. And I mean, it was just amazing to see those little kids' faces and to be a blessing. So thank you, church, for loving our community. And this week, we'll be going to 6 schools on the west side. We're going to the Child Crisis Center, Lemoore Homes, CPS, and there's others. So there's about another 4,000 toys that we're going to be giving out as a church family this week. Isn't that awesome? Hey, let's prepare to give. Of course, this is a Sunday morning service, so we're going to receive our offering now. And the Bible says, the Apostle Paul wrote in 2 Corinthians, that God loves a cheerful giver. And I pray that that's always our spirit as a church. It has been for decades, and it will be going forward, that we are cheerful givers. And it's easy when you understand why you give and what you give for. We give because God's given to us. Amen? We give to honor God, to glorify God. We give to keep God first in our finances, and we know we need that. We don't just need God first in our marriage and in our careers and in our dreams. We need him first in our finances. Can I get a good amen? Hey, I believe we give to be a blessing to our community, and that's what we did last week and this coming week. We give to provide for the church. You know, the system that God created is that the men and women within the church freely give, and it provides for the church. We understand that, right? Right? We understand that's the system. But we also give out of faith, knowing that God rewards our giving. The Bible says that when we give, it will be given back unto us. Good measure, pressed down, shaken together, and running over. How many of you have seen God do good things in your life through your giving? Amen. Let's pray. Father, we honor you, we glorify you. We thank you for who you are and what you do. Lord, as we give today, we pray that your hand of provision is on us as a church. Every person in this room and every person watching online, as they give today, I believe that you are moving in their lives to meet their needs. In Jesus' name, amen. The information to give is on the screen. You can even set up recurring giving when you give online. It's great, but there was also envelopes as well. Thank you for your faithfulness and your giving. A couple more small things. Listen, we were blessed with so much food that we fed the 1,000 families and have enough left over to have a drive-through food giveaway in every service today. So if you need food, when the service is over, get in your car and go to the back of the building. There will be security, and our team will be back there to direct you, and we'll give you food today. Isn't that amazing? I mean, come on, how awesome is that, right? And then I just want to share with you the services coming up. We have amazing Christmas Eve and New Year's Eve services. The Christmas Eve schedule is a little different this year because Christmas Day is on a Sunday, so we're having church online that Sunday. So we've added a service on December 23rd. So Friday night and Saturday night, Christmas Eve, East and West, 6 p.m., and then the next week, our annual New Year's Eve service, where we'll have fireworks and we'll have church and then the big party. And we have two services, East and West, on that Saturday night, 5 and 7 o'clock. And then Sunday morning, we'll have church at home, church online for New Year's Day. So we're going to all come, right? We're going to all come, right? Right. All right. We have an amazing rest of the show. Please enjoy.
The oxen live. the Son of God appeared. Rejoice, rejoice, Emmanuel shall come to thee, O safe the way that leads on high, and close the path to misery. Rejoice, rejoice, Emmanuel shall come to thee, O Israel. You tore the night apart and rent the silent skies. Your glory breaking through the dark. And here our worlds collide, divinity in man confined. This great design drawn out for me. Life is now forever changed. Our eyes be lifted up, this great eternal hope.
this great design drawn out for me. Emmanuel, God with us. Emmanuel, heaven whispered out in our darkness. Glory pierced the night. We were broken, but now we're lifted up. King of heaven, God is here.
I love that song. That's actually my favorite song. It's become my favorite Christmas song. And it just brings into focus exactly why we're here. It brings into our remembrance the true priorities of what Christmas is about. Christmas is about a lot of things. There's a lot of things that happen. There's kids' musicals, there's shopping, there's presents, there's family gatherings, there's traveling, there's church, there's trees and lights and gifts for our kids. But at Christmas, we celebrate the greatest gift ever given to mankind, and that is the gift of Jesus Christ coming into this earth as our personal Lord Jesus is so many things to us. He is our refuge and our fortress. He is our high priest. He is our friend. He is our Lord. He's our healer, our deliverer. He's our ever-present help in our time of need. He is our provider. He is many things to all of us. But above all of those things, the most powerful thing that Jesus is to us is that he is our Savior. Amen. All throughout Scripture, we discover God's great plan to bring redemption to mankind. In fact, from the very first word in the book of Genesis to the final amen in the book of Revelation, you discover that everything God did from the first moment of time until this moment, right here, right now, on this beautiful Sunday morning in December in El Paso, Texas, everything God has done, is doing, and will do for the rest of our time on earth is being done and designed to get redemption into your life. This plan that the Father had was birthed and, of course, completed with the arrival of Jesus. And what was the purpose of God's redemption plan? The purpose of his plan, simply put, was to save us from our sins. This plan was founded in God's unconditional, unwavering love for us, as we see in John 3:16. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever would believe in him would not perish, but would have everlasting life. Upon receiving this promise, God gives each and every one of us a covenant of a divine relationship that he has guaranteed each and every one of us through the blood of Jesus Christ. And that covenant comes with amazing promises that are all sealed by the power of the Holy Spirit. This redemption plan made it possible for all of us to live knowing that no matter what happens to us in our time here on earth, that when our time is done, we will immediately be present with our Savior Jesus in heaven. And we will live in heaven for eternity, dancing in streets of gold, worshiping in the temple, celebrating the beauty and the splendor and the majesty of the creator of the universe. We will be in fellowship with other saints, saints that have names of books written in the Bible, saints that were our moms and dads, our friends and our families, and we will live in eternal worship to the King of Kings, the Lord of Lords, our Savior Jesus Christ. This redemption plan, though, did not just pave the way for eternity, although that would have been enough. I say this in church all the time. Salvation in Jesus is enough for all of us to worship God every day of our lives. But the beauty of the God we serve is that he is not the God of enough. He is the God of more than enough. And the redemption plan that the Father created did not stop at eternity. The redemption plan God created for you, for me, and for anyone who would believe in Jesus as their Lord and Savior started with eternity, but it also includes your everyday life. To quote the words of Jesus, he said, "I have come that they may have life and that they may have it more abundantly." See, God wants you to enjoy a life of hope, peace, faith, victory, forgiveness, vision, purpose, and calling in your life. God cares about your eternity as the priority, but he also cares about your Mondays and Tuesdays. Imagine how excited the Father must have been when Jesus came to the earth. I picture myself on Christmas morning when I watch my kids open, you know, the one big gift, the one they really wanted, the one that they said, please, 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 I'll never disobey again. And you know that they're lying through their little precious teeth. And as they open it, I don't know who's happier, the kid or me, to see their joy. But can you imagine how happy the Father was when he sent this gift, his son, to become a man, to be born of a virgin, to start a 33-year journey that would take him to walk up onto a cross, to give up his life so that you and I could have life everlasting. Today, no matter who you are, no matter what your life looks like, I want you to know that you are loved by God the Father. Today, no matter who you are, no matter what your life looks like, I want you to know that you can be saved by Jesus Christ. Today, no matter who you are, no matter what your life may look like, there is a hope and a future for you through God's redemption plan. Today, no matter who you are, no matter what your life may have looked like, God the Father loves you, he cherishes you, he values you at the highest level. And he wants nothing more than for his redemption to reach into your soul and to save you now and for eternity. All throughout the Bible, even before the birth of Christ, God writes the beautiful story of redemption through Jesus, and he shows us how our lives intertwine with it. Today, I just want to share two simple points with you before we can continue this incredible musical. And number one is that any person can be a part of God's redemption plan. And that includes you. In Joshua chapter 2, we read the story of a woman named Rahab who was a harlot, a prostitute, a sinner. Joshua, who at this time was leading the nation of Israel into the promised land, sends two spies to check out a city called Jericho. It was a well-fortified city. It was, on paper, it should have been a real challenge for the nation of Israel to overcome this city. So the spies come to Rahab's house, and she brings them into her house to provide security and shelter for them, because the leader of the nation of Jericho had found out that spies were in the land, and he sent his guards to find them and to kill them. Rahab hid the men, and in verse 9 of Joshua chapter 2, she goes on to tell them, "I know that the Lord has given our land to you." Verse 12 and 13, she says, "Now therefore I beg you, swear to me by the Lord, since I have shown you kindness, that you also will show kindness to my father's house, to give me a true token and spare my father, my mother, my brothers, my sisters, and all that they have, and deliver our lives from sure death." The spies of the nation of Israel responded to Rahab's plea. They responded to her protection and to her security, and they promised to save Rahab and any person of her family who would get inside her house when they came back to overcome Jericho. She let the spies down out of a window of her house with a scarlet cord. The spies told her to hang the same scarlet cord out of her house when they returned, and it would be a sign of the covenant that they made with her and that that sign of the covenant would provide security and protection for her and her family. The red cord was a symbol of a divine promise that they made. And in the Old Testament, the Hebrew word for the word cord literally means trusting faith. It expressed what a cord did for you, that it provided security, that it tied you to another person in safety, that it was something or someone that you could rely and depend on. The red cord symbolizes God showing up for us time and time again. It symbolizes the covenant that you and I have with Jesus, a covenant that offers us security, that offers us protection, that offers us provision, a covenant that is not just for us, but can be extended to our loved ones, our families, our friends. The cord ties us to Jesus, who is the guarantor of your safety and your eternity through redemption. We learn, in fact, later in Matthew, that Rahab, this sinner, this harlot, was in fact in the lineage of Jesus Christ himself. Every Christmas, I believe we are reminded powerfully of how God has shown up, how he is still showing up, and we are encouraged that he will continue to show up for us in our lives. Anyone can be a part of God's redemption plan, which leads to the second point, that when redemption comes to one, quite often it comes to many. Time and time again in Scripture, we see the redemption of one lead to the redemption of the people around them. We saw that Rahab was redeemed, and it also redeemed her family, her father, her mother, her brothers, and her sisters. In Luke 19, Jesus declares salvation for Zacchaeus. And for Zacchaeus, his entire family became saved. The Bible says, "For the Son of Man came to find and to restore the lost." The Bible says that Jesus stands at the door of people's hearts and he knocks, and any person that opens that door would come into their lives. We saw in the Old Testament that Abraham's redemption led to the redemption of his son, his son's son, and generations to follow, so many so that the Bible says that it is more than the dust of the earth can be counted. Of course, we saw that Moses' redemption led to the redemption of many others. We saw that Joshua and Caleb's redemption led to the redemption of many, many others. We saw in the lives of Peter, James, and John, in the lives of Thomas and Paul, that their redemption would lead to the redemption of millions of others. A man decades ago was born again in a tent revival. That tent revival went on for weeks, and only one man gave his life to Christ as his Lord and Savior. That young man's name, of course, was Billy Graham. And his redemption would lead to the redemption of millions and millions of other people for decades to come. 50 years ago, a man tapped another man on the back shoulder on the campus of UTEP. And he led that man to Christ. And through that man and his wife's redemption, a church was born in El Paso. And after one man tapped another man on the shoulder named Charles, Thousands of people have been led into redemption after the one man's. My friend, your decisions matter. In fact, they can be life-altering, not just for you, but for everyone in your circle, your family, your spouse, your kids, your grandkids, your coworkers, your friends, and future generations. There is only one thing that can stop God's love and redemption in your life, and that one thing is you. You have to choose to receive His love. You have to choose to receive His salvation. You have to choose to receive His redemption. And I pray that you will choose to follow the red cord of redemption like millions have before all of us. Thank you. incredible. Just want to take a moment and talk to everyone here and everyone watching online. You know, that song we're singing and the song we're about to sing represent, or they refer to, the night divine. And why do we single out that one night? The night Jesus was born was not just another night. The reason it was not just another night is because this was not just another baby being born. We mark the birth of Jesus because at the birth of Jesus, everything changed in the course of humanity. Before Jesus came, there was separation from God. There was no relationship with God. There was frustration between God and man. But Jesus would come to pay a price, to give a gift, and to start a 33-year journey to walk freely up onto a cross. And his blood would be shed so that ours would not be. He would be made sin so that we could all be forgiven. He would be rejected by his own father so that you and I can be accepted. He would be made poor so that you and I could be well supplied. Jesus, the God of blessing, would become a curse. And he would bear the wrath of the Father so that you and I can live under an open heaven, blessed by God all the days of our lives, where there is now no more wrath, no more judgment, and no more anger. There is only love, hope, grace, mercy, and peace. Amen. This redemption cord can be extended to any person. No matter who you are, no matter where you've been. Whether you've been a sinner or a saint, whether your deeds would be described in the worst term or the best, I want you to know that God loves you. He cherishes you. He forgives you. He will deliver you. He will save you. And Jesus will redeem you from the curse of sin. And if you would simply open up your heart to God, to believe and to confess Jesus as Lord and Savior of your life, you will be saved for eternity. But you can also leave here knowing that God is for you. He will never be against you. And he will want to empower you to live a life of joy, peace, happiness, and wisdom. The decision I'm going to offer you to make is the most important decision any human can make on this earth today. Why is it so important? Because it's the only decision that bears eternal consequence. I'm going to give every person in this room the opportunity to make Jesus Lord of your life so that you, like many others in this room and millions before you, can live out the rest of your time on earth knowing that no matter what happens, you're going to heaven. But you can also live knowing that God is with you. If you've never prayed this prayer, what we call the prayer of salvation, I invite you, rather let me say, I implore you to pray this prayer with us today. In a moment, I'm going to lead the church through the prayer. And I'm going to ask you to join with us. Or maybe you're here today and you would say to me, Jared, at one point I made Jesus Lord of my life, but I've since turned away. I'm far from God. I don't serve God anymore, but I want to come back. I've been doing it on my own and it's not working out. I need to come back to God. Is there still redemption for me? And the answer is yes. In fact, I believe the very reason you're here today is for this moment. Yes, the singing, the dancing, the lights, it was all beautiful. But the only thing that really matters is that you come back to God today. I like to put it like this. Maybe you're here or you're watching online, and you know on some level in your heart that you are not right with God. Whatever that means to you, but you know you're not right with God. You might believe in God. You might even believe that Jesus is Lord. He's just not your Lord. You're not right with God, and you're here, but you're broken. You're hurting. You're lost. You may even be tormented on some level. You're not right with God, but here's the good news. You can get right with God right here, right now. And you don't have to go figure out everything that's wrong in your life to come to the one who is right. In fact, Jesus himself said, come to the one who's right, and he'll help make you right. See, you can bring the mess in your life to God, and he doesn't reject you. In fact, he helps to clean it up. Would you bow your heads and close your eyes? If you're here today and you'd say to me, Jared, I want to pray this prayer. Jared, I want to go to heaven. I want to make Jesus Lord and Savior of your life. I want to dance in streets of gold. I want to leave here knowing God is for me and not against me. I want my sins forgiven. Jared, I just need to come back to God. I used to serve God, but I don't anymore. Jared, I need to get right with God. I've been sensing I need a change, and now I recognize that the change starts with me getting right with God. Here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to count to three. And if you want to pray this prayer with us today, before we pray on the count of three, I'm just going to ask you to raise your hand up in the air as a sign of faith. Plus, I just want to know who I'm praying with. Nobody's looking around. It's just me and you. But if you say to me, Jared, include me in this prayer. I want to get right with God today once and for all. Today is my day. This is my moment. There's going to be a lot of you because you know you need this. Don't let another day go by. On the count of three, if you want Jesus to redeem you and to come into your life as your friend and your Savior, boldly raise your hand up. One, two, three. Come on, raise them up. Yes, thank you, thank you. There's at least 20 to 30 hands in every section. I see you. God bless you. Entire rows over here to my right. God bless you all. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight people next to each other. God bless you all. Is there anyone else before we pray? Okay, you can put your hands down. Would everybody look at me? I want to tell you what's about to happen. The Bible says that when one person prays the prayer of salvation and make Jesus Lord and Savior of their life, that all the angels in heaven stop. They recognize you, they see you, and then they worship God because you are now part of a heavenly family. So as we pray, recognize that all of heaven is rejoicing that you are going to pray this prayer today. Would you repeat after me? Say, Heavenly Father, I give you my life. I give you my heart and my soul. And I make Jesus my Lord and Savior. Forgive my sins. Put my past behind me. And take me to the life you have for me. In Jesus' name, amen. Before we finish the show, can we give these people a great round of applause? Welcome to the family of God. Would love for you to get your phone out and scan that. When the service is over, you can go to our Connect Centers. We have people out there. We want to give you some gifts. We'd love for you to come back to church. We're going to finish the show here with this amazing group of singers leading us in O Holy Night. God bless you.
Stars are brightly shining. It is the night of our dear Savior's birth. sin and error pining till he appeared and the soul felt its worth. A thrill of hope, the weary world rejoices, for yonder breathes a new
Can we just take a moment and thank the incredible, abundant worship team and band? And our production team, sound, lighting, video. I also want to just recognize that all the choreography and dancing was done by Urban Music Dance Academy. And I just want to point out, a lot of them, they've been rehearsing since like August and September. This is a big deal to make this happen. So can we just give everybody another round of applause? Now, above all else, on the count of three, we're going to give the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords the greatest shout of praise in this church. One, two, three. Come on, church. Praise the Lord. Hey, we love you. God bless you. Thank you for being here. You are dismissed. Don't forget, we have the drive-through food giveaway. We have one more if you want to text people and tell them to come, starting at 12:30. And then next Sunday at the West Side, we're going to do it three more times. But those of you that come to church on the East Side, we'll still be having church here on the East Side also, okay? God bless you. Have a great week. Joy.